So right, we're up at 3:30 a.m. on 3 hours sleep because we're driving 4.5 hours to the other side of the country to surprise my girlfriend, who actually lives about 6.5 hours away. But we're stopping off and we're going to do some skydiving first. All right, boys and girls, we have arrived. Right, so this is called audible. It beeps when you are too low or like a certain altitude. So you know when to pull your parachute. And this is an altie, which basically does the same thing, but it's like on the screen. Right, people, great fucking success. Didn't die. We've just done the 4 months post-meso group. Skydived. It's only 6 months at least for a full recovery. We fucking did it. Ocean of me, where you gonna run to? Ocean of me, where you gonna run to? Nicotine is bad unless I'm absolutely fucking wired at a festival and I love it. But my mate Luca brought me one of these elf bars the other day and it's like watermelon shisha flavor or something. And it tastes so damn good. It literally is like you're having food. A melon rain and a melon flavored shisha elf bar. It's fucking amazing, mate. It's literally better than normal food.
Come here, little bitch.
Oh, imagine if I wasn't actually wasn't there. I know, like, it'd disappoint
me. I'm not falling for it. I look like a rat.
You always look like a rat. Just woke up, it's the next day, and I feel like I have been in a parachute accident. Probably because I was in a parachute accident yesterday. Right, so we are going to iFly today, which is like an indoor skydiving place, and we're gonna train, and we're gonna go to the spa, and we're gonna get some sushi. So what an exciting day on this one's day off.
Just one day off, because I work on the weekends.
Basically, don't crash the car in front.
He doesn't trust me, because he's racist.
Because she's an Asian, she's a woman, which makes her a shit driver times two. Anyway, right, Queen asked me what I wanted for my birthday, and I was like, I literally don't want anything. So I was like, I want you to go and do your skydiving license. So I'm basically going to be forcing Queen into doing a skydiving license soon. Seeing as she's got that in a few weeks' time, I thought what we could do is go to the wind tunnel, which is like indoor skydiving. She's never done it before, and do like a few minutes in there to get... You're excited for your first ever indoor skydive?
Yes, indeed.
Your face is going to look so chubby and be like all blown around. Your little cheeks going to be like this.
I'm like a chipmunk. That's so sick.
You're going to be like that, okay? You got this.
Do you look right?
You look sick, yeah. I think everyone, well, Queen grossly underestimates how difficult this shit actually is. It looks easy. It's like a baby learning to walk. It's like you just have no clue how to move in this medium of air because you've never done it before. Like, once you get it, you don't forget it, it's okay. But if you've never done it before, it's like so fucking difficult. Basically, you go in like this arch position where your hips are the lowest point, and because your hips are the lowest point, it keeps you like stable on your belly. So like you want to fly in that arch, but it's really difficult because every little input you make will change you're basically a wing. So every little input that you make with your legs, your hands, your arms will change the way that you fly. So it's fucking hard, man, but she's doing really good. How was it?
Good. I mean, I was so dry. I was like,
did really, really good. The fact that you're going like up and down within the first 5 minutes of doing it, which is actually really quite hard, is proper rad. And you didn't flail at all either. Like a lot of people like kick their legs because it's like human instinct to try and stand up and put your hand down. The plan now is we're gonna go to Flex and Tone gym in Manchester. It's probably my favorite gym in Manchester. It's like in this like industrial old factory building. It's like proper dirty meathead bodybuilding gym, which is what I love. So trashy. Don't disrespect the best gym in Manchester, right? Or you get stabbed. Sick gym. That's the sort of gym where I'd love to train if I lived here all the time. If you're ever in Manchester, check it out, because the day pass as well. For Queen, it was £3. For me, it was it four or five?
Five.
Less than half the price of like a shitty pure gym. The gym's like a million times better. I kind of like the fact that the gym is cheaper for women than it is men, because like in this political correct day and age, obviously that is probably not legal to do, but I think it's kind of cool. You know, I like a bit of division between the sexes because I'm a misogynist.
Mum even says that.
Huh? My mum says I'm a misogynist, yeah. Damn fucking right.
Is this a time where you guys should cancel them? Like, it's 2022, guys.
Yeah, well, let's bring it back.
Come on, I'm hungry.
Oh. Right, we're going to Itsu, which I used to think was pretty dead, but seeing as I'm dieting, it's number one, really good macros. Number two, keeps my Asian girlfriend happy, got sushi. Number three, it's actually pretty fucking tasty, get the right stuff. Right, half of those, two of those, and all of this is 800 calories. Absolutely banging. Hoisin duck bao buns will change your fucking life as well.
Right, guys, this is like so simple, but like it's like one of my favorite sushi. It's so clean, it's so simple, and it's so easy to eat.
Oi, so, hang them out. Don't call my audience guys, like your audience, right? It's my fan base, my YouTube channel, pipe the fuck down. Is that one of those girlfriends that like marries you and wants to get all your money?
I'm here
like,
to get all his followers.
Yeah, she's getting a bit too comfortable, I think. Right, so I'm being a proper influencer today. And when you're an influencer, you get influencer privilege, which means you can email places. I literally never do this, so I find it so cringe. But you can email places and be like, hi guys, I'm an influencer. I will mention you in my vlog or Instagram post if you give me free shit. And I've decided that I should probably monopolize on this. So this place kindly let us go in for free. In return for like an IG post. Right, so basically what you do is you walk to the front and be like, excuse me, I'm an influencer, fucking let me run out. And then people like bow down to you. Because if you're not verified on Instagram, you're worthless piece of shit. My little drowned rat. Right, people, that was a random vlog and a couple of days of in the life of Mo Samuels with my girlfriend, and that's kind of what we got up to the last few days. Hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know if you liked it. Let me know if you drop a comment if you did like it, if you actually seen this, because I don't think a lot of people are going to see it, because like I said, YouTube algorithm hates any kind of content like this that I do. Even though I really enjoy making it, it doesn't like push it to anyone. So drop a comment for the algorithm. I see all your freaking comments. I always read the first like ones in the first 12 hours. I always get read to every comment and get back to as many as I can. Video ideas, let me know down below. We've got lots of content coming, lots of content that I filmed. Just been a bit slack on the uploads recently because my editor has gone on holiday and I have been in Portugal filming some stuff, partying for like 3 days straight, and felt like my soul had left my body, and I probably overdid it a little bit and have wanted to kill myself for the last week. Not actually kill myself, but I've I haven't felt good the last week because we definitely overdid it at the festival, but nonetheless we move. Lots of love, people. Hope you enjoyed the video. Peace out. I love you to bits. Thank you. Good night.